In today's video, I'm showing you how to make the best Dutch oven chicken you'll ever taste, and it's so easy to make. Here are the ingredients that you will need for this recipe: mild cheddar cheese, bacon, Mountain Dew, chicken, potatoes, and carrots, and the full recipe will be in the description box down below. Let's start with bacon. You'll need 1 pound of bacon, diced. Next, we're going to add our diced bacon to a Dutch oven pan. Now, this one is a 12-inch Dutch oven pan. I've had this for about 16 years. I use it every single week, multiple times a week. I absolutely love it. I'll try to find one similar and link it in the description box down below. Now go ahead and add your bacon to the pan, and we're just going to cook this bacon until it's nice and crispy. While the bacon is cooking, we're going to take 4 to 5 chicken breasts and dice them and set them aside. Next, we need a shallow dish and some flour. Add 1.5 cups of flour to the dish. Now we're going to work in sections and start coating the chicken pieces with flour. Make sure that they are thoroughly coated. Each piece has flour on all sides of the chicken. And then go ahead and shake off the excess flour, and we're going to set them on a plate. Make sure that you're stirring your bacon occasionally so that it doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan and so that it cooks evenly. Make sure that you cook your bacon nice and crispy. We'll add it to our recipe later. Now go ahead and take a slotted spoon. And this is just a bowl with a paper towel on top. This is going to soak up any excess grease. So make sure that you drain any grease from the bacon and place on the paper towel. Now set your bacon aside and we will add it at the end. Now to your bacon grease, you're going to add your diced chicken. And I'm sorry about the lighting on this. I don't know what my camera was doing, but it would not adjust to the light. So go ahead and add this to your bacon grease and you're going to give this a really good stir. Make sure all those chicken pieces are coated in the bacon grease. And then what you're going to do is turn the burner off on your stove and let this sit. Next, you're going to peel and dice 6 potatoes, and then we're going to add them to our chicken mixture. Make sure that you dice them a little bit larger because we're going to cook them in the oven for about an hour and a half. And if you have small, tiny pieces of potato, then they'll overcook and be mushy and too soft. So make sure that your pieces are a little bit larger. Next, you're going to peel and chop 6 carrots, and then you're going to add them to the potato and chicken mixture. Next, you're going to place them in a 350 degree oven, and then you're going to pour the Mountain Dew on top of this mixture. So what I do is I don't measure the Mountain Dew. You just want to pour it over the top of this until all of the potatoes and carrots are completely covered with Mountain Dew. When all of your carrots and potatoes are completely covered, then you're going to place the Dutch oven lid on top, and then you'll cook this for 1 hour and 30 minutes. After an hour and a half, remove this from your oven, and then if you'll notice, this is why you cover everything with the Mountain Dew. It'll soak up a lot of those juices. So now give this a really good stir. We're going to bring up all those chicken pieces from the bottom, stir this really well, and then we're going to add our cheese. Next, you'll add 2 cups of mild cheddar cheese. Right before serving, go ahead and add your crispy bacon back to the Dutch oven. You want to do this right before you serve it because you want the bacon to still be kind of crispy. That's what makes it really, really yummy. And then stir this in really well, and then it's ready to serve. Serve this in a bowl. You can also serve it with a side of crusty bread to dip in there, or you can serve it as is. This is so good. It doesn't look that pretty. It's not one of those meals that's eye-catching, but I'm telling you, your taste buds will be so happy when you try this. Thank you so much for joining me in this video. Please subscribe if you haven't already. I post a cooking video every single Wednesday, and I post a cleaning video every single Saturday. So we'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.